Hello everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Jak 2. And last we left off, we were gonna see what the hell Bruder wanted us to do.
It's Brother Jak and his little orangey pal. Thank the totem I sees you. You helped lurkers once time. You help us twos?
Look, Bruder, we've got our own problems to deal with right now.
But you no bid to do ruckus, you cause it, dig? I know all caves like Back of Claw, and our tomb, nowhere there. Now metalheads find hidden lurker village in caves. They bite and hurt village real bad, and me lurker brothers trapped like animals.
Hello, they are animals.
We're no longer evil lurking bad to bones, orangey boy. We good now. Metalheads are bad. They is enemies.
Yeah, I guess we're all on the same boat now.
And this ship is sinking fast, brother.
Please, save six lurker brothers quick, and Bruder will kiss you foot.
Okay. I don't know how much they want them to kiss their feet, but hey, he did get us a piece of the Seal of Mar that got us ambushed by a couple hundred Crimson Guards at the port. So, how bad can his rewards be, right? We shall never know. Alright, where are they? Ah. Oh, that's only five. There's a sixth one. So, in both the little vegetation areas and one in the city area. Or two in the city area. Okay. This shouldn't be too difficult. Just might take a little bit of time for the traveling. I hope we don't have to bring them all the way back to Bruder's place. Well, these aren't bad, but... Huh. How will we take this down? Ooh, this looks like it'll do perfect. One shot. That's what I'm talking about. Oh, where'd he at? How did he get back there? Whoa. Oh, hold on. We don't have to bring him to Bruder's place, then where are we bringing him to? Oh, we're traveling to the unknown. To the unknown place to drop off a giant brute. If one of these things punched someone, it would probably hurt like a sungbaudi. I gotta stop thinking about that damn prank call thing. I don't know if anyone's watched Onage prank calls, but this dude, he gets bored sometimes, and he calls people, and God, is he ever funny at it. He's great at prank calling. He pretends to be an Asian guy. Everything's like a sangbaudi to him. Wow, how are they getting all the way back there? Is that like a glitch whenever you use the peacemaker on him? Come on, I'm tired of getting shocked. Oh, well, I guess for the three different areas the two lurkers are in each, we have three different drop-off points, or that's just my guess. I'd hope so, because I don't want to get all the way over there and then have to come back here and... Yeah. Let's see. I also got to find a way to get Sony Vegas Pro so I could put Audacity into it and record. Wrong series. Anyways. So back through the bazaar. And this bazaar connects to a lot of places, which I guess would be natural because it's a bazaar. And it's futuristic with stalls. I don't understand why. Here, I have a stall full of apples. It's like you have like a scrolling stall with an iPod Touch I could connect it to. I mean, you'd think something like that would be out, but hey, whatever. Like, that makes me think, like, all the movies, it's like 2029 or something. And all this stuff is happening. They have all these crazy highways and stuff. And by the time technology advances so fast, which is the great thing about it, but by the time that would actually happen, like, that time would be here, technology would probably be a lot better. Besides for that thing that everyone thought in 2015 there was going to be flying cars for whatever reason. It doesn't go by that fast. Or actually it does, it's just not released to the public that fast. They made an actual flying car. This was in the news. They made a flying car when I was like 5. Or 7. One of those. But they said that everything it takes to make them those wouldn't be ready for the average person on the street until at least 100 years from now because of the sheer amount of cost. And yes, I'm waiting for it to get away from the water so it doesn't... Oh shit, I forgot about the jump. So it doesn't fall into the water. And then I get screwed out of a mission because, you know, I wouldn't doubt if that can happen. Whoa! Cool. I really thought I was screwed for a second. Oh, goddammit, I gotta turn around. Let's run these dudes over. Okay, had a call on Skype and had to answer that, so I'm finally back. About 8 hours later. You know what's the worst thing about just starting to record a part? What was the worst thing about whenever you're doing post-commentary while you're recording a part? It's, you don't have a damn thing. You can't think of a damn thing to say or talk about at the very beginning. You just kinda, as you start talking, you get into the mood and you just bring up something random. That's how post-commentary, in my experience, has worked. But like, God, stop shooting me, you asshole. Hey, dumbass! You, yeah, you! I'm gonna have to switch vehicles. Come on, get on! Yeah! That was a totally unexpected awesomeness. But yeah. Right whenever you start to post-commentate anything, it's really difficult, unless you have a list on the side of you, which I have never used. I can't go by a list and decide that's what I'm gonna talk about. But if you ever had a list, if you don't have a list, it's a bitch. Seriously, it is though. Like, right now, I have no idea what I'm gonna talk about. Every time I start one of these parts, I have no idea what I'm gonna talk about. I don't think of anything in advance. Actually, yes, I do think of plenty of stuff in advance. It's just whenever I click record, I don't remember any of it. So if it comes to me during the part, then I talk about it. If not, well, it'll get there one day. One day, probably not, or probably pretty far in the future. But what do we have left? Oh god, Ven. Oh, every time we go there, something that I don't want to do pops up. I'm looking at my microphone settings right here, and it's showing that my voice is coming out ear-splitting loud on here, like the little volume radar is kinda going off crazy. If I would yell right now, I would break someone's eardrum. That would be oof. Well, I'm not gonna do that. It's like whenever I'm in a car and someone's playing Screamo or Heavy Metal Metallica or whatever. I don't listen to none of that shit. I mean, I'm not a fan of that shit. Just my personal opinion. I know a lot of people are, but I don't see why, but they are. Well, one of my friends, actually, a lot of my friends are. And whenever I'm in their cars, they like to blare that shit in my ear, pretend that they lost their goddamn hearing, and put it on at full volume. And I'm thinking, they're like, this is low, what's wrong with you? I'm thinking, God, I have horrible eyes, not horrible ears. I actually have really good ears. I can sit in my room, across the house, and listen to people's conversations in the living room. Like, I'm not kidding, I've done it plenty. Whenever someone's in a car next to me and they whisper something to the person next to them because they didn't want me to hear or whatever, or I looked away and they said that, I'll turn around to them and say, why you say that?
Stop going. I've got good news and bad news. The good news is Core tells me we've got enough power online to keep the shield walls up. So for now, the city's safe. But I don't know how long the system can hold.
And the bad news?
We've detected a cluster of metalhead eggs growing up at the strip mine site. Now you gotta go back there and find a way to destroy those eggs before they turn into a whole new army of creatures.
I noticed the crane was lifting a large metal container. If we could jump onto the container, we could drop the crate from above.
Hi! Jump! Drop! Why don't I like the sound of that?
Come on, Dax. Let's go.
Nothing so far.
Yeah, where is that at? Man, that's not cool. I don't know where it is. Alright, I feel like my Jak and Daxter knowledge has failed me. I've played through part 3 like 100 times as a kid. Played through part 1 a couple of times, including when this collection came out. I played part 1 before anything else. Actually, more specifically, I played this game, recorded a couple of parts, like 3 or 4. And while I was rendering the videos into HD, which takes about 30 minutes each, I was playing Jak 1. Jak 1's an extremely short game, but it's one of those awesome classics. Where the hell am I supposed to go? I could have swore I'd need to be back here. No? Oh, look, a precursor orb. Cool. Hmm. Maybe. No? Those are the eggs back there. But we went up there for something else already. What that? Oh, I guess we go there. Where's that end at? Look, right. Oh, I feel stupid. I guess we could go there? Yeah? No? Maybe? Did I see that yet? No, I didn't. It has to be up there. I guess we could get to that path from up there. No? I is confused. I betcha it's something right in my face. Like, it's out in the open just sitting there screaming at me. A couple of you are probably screaming at the computer. It's that way, retard. Because if I was watching me, I would be screaming that too. I very well would. Yeah, but yeah, back to the heavy metal Metallica. So, yesterday actually, I found a video on YouTube that at one point in the video, the volume just gets so incredibly loud, and it's like this loud screeching metal sound that it could probably make you go deaf. And, well, I don't have any remorse for that. I mean, he already fucking made my ears nearly bleed. No, we can't get up there either, shit. I'm running out of ideas. So I sent him that. He's like, I'm having issues hearing in my left ear. I'm like, I have issues hearing in both my ear when I'm in your car. So I think that was some necessary revenge on my part. Oh. Oh, really? Is that the... It was right in my face the whole time. Oh my god, why? Oh shit. No, no, yes, no. Okay. Next time, we'll actually go the right way. Thank you guys for watching.